Well, for round 8 of the Women's National Basketball League, Narelle Fletcher and I were at Logan Metro Stadium for the must-win game, Narelle, between the Logan Thunder and the Canberra Capitals. Both these sides were not noted for their defence, and in the first half, it was pretty electrifying, the offensive pace, before things slowed down as Canberra took control.
Look, it took a little while for this match to warm up. We didn't see any score, so it was pretty much a bit of a defensive slog to some degree for the first 3 minutes. But after there, like you said, it just opened up. The glad wrap came off the rings, and both teams were able to shoot well. Certainly for Logan Thunder, Laurie Kane was the catalyst for the start for them.
We expected that. Here she is on cue. She made 4 3-pointers in the first half. That's her game. She is a specialist in that regard. And Canberra did not have an answer at the defensive end, but Jess Bibby could answer at the offensive end. She was electrified.
Well, I think it was really important for Canberra to make sure they stayed close and stayed in the game early on, particularly knowing that they were backing up from the game in Townsville the night before. They'd only just arrived in Brisbane and come straight to the centre. So it was always going to be that they had to switch on straight away, and I think that they were pretty happy with a tight, fairly evenly matched first quarter.
They were. Logan led by a point at quarter time, but then they trailed by 4 points at half time as Natalie Hurst and Abby Bishop started to take control of the game.
Well, look, both of those players, you know, we didn't see Natalie Hurst figure on the score sheet much in the first half, but Abby Bishop, well, look, you know, she pretty much had a field day inside because she had numerous opportunities for mismatches. She was being guarded quite frequently by Tegan Cunningham. Now, Abby Bishop's tough to guard by the best defenders in the world in the paint, but that's way out of Tegan Cunningham's comfort zone.
The second half really was Canberra's, wasn't it, Narelle? They cranked up the defence. Emma Langford, who scores here, didn't have a massive influence. She was hampered by foul trouble, as were a few players. Tegan Cunningham was really the only player who was able to consistently find the bottom of the net for the Logan Thunder. And as all players got a little bit frustrated late in the game, Canberra had more options and more talent.
Look, we were waiting. It was like Canberra were just, they had control of this match. They were controlling the tempo, and we were waiting and waiting just for the game to open up. It took right through until late in that fourth quarter, actually, before it actually happened. But to our surprise, when it looked like Canberra were in total control, well, Logan Thunder came back again.
They did, but then Natalie Hurst was able to ice it. Look at that brilliant pass from her. She found Abby Bishop on the bootlaces, and then she scored the last 4 points of the game, all from the free throw line, as Canberra were able to close out an 11-point win. They had four players in double figures, plus Alex Bunton with a career-high 16 rebounds, and it underlined their dominance in the end. And Canberra won the match. They defeated the Logan Thunder 79-68.